A visit at the Albertine region where the oil pipelines are going to pass. The legislators say that they were shocked to learn that people to be affected by the pipeline are being compensated at a fee as low as 2 million Uganda shillings for an acre of land. An amount the residents say is as far too little compared to the value of land in the area. To make matters worse, these fans will not come on time.
The values that were used to pay off these people, I think it's about 3.5 million. And yet in Ulisa itself today, to get an acre of 3.5 million anywhere else is impossible. So they were wondering, if their land goes at 3.5, then where are they going to get similar land in Ulisa?
The legislatures are now pushing government to develop uniform compensation rates for land to protect people, especially from the speculators, so that they are not cheated. The director of petroleum at the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development in Hanimaringa, however, noted that the question of land has continued to cripple the oil pipeline works if government does not come out to clear on the amendments in the Land Act. He is worried that Uganda might lose out on oil.
Don't look at the rates, that these are the rates for oil. These are the rates for Honorable Mutabazi. When is he going to buy land? If the land is 10 million, it should be 10 million across the board. Not to say that this one is for the oil company and 2 million is for the local person. It's the rate which they will use. If there's a dispute, it's the rate which they will go to court and use.
In this meeting, legislators and local leaders who were present also raised a complaint that they have not been fully engaged in oil matters, such that they too prepare people at the grassroots on how to benefit.
I am not here to fight because I've had my own wars. I am here to advise you. We need to engage these politicians, both local. I'm not surprised members of parliament. I think this is the first, if not the second, meeting I've interacted with members of parliament who should have been involved earlier into all these policies you are making.
Local governments are supposed to come up with local rates in respect to compensation. At times they don't have the capacity. I think government there can come in and facilitate these local governments to be able to update their rates. But the most important thing is to engage, be it parliament, be it communities.
The Uganda-Tanzania Crude Oil Pipeline, also known as the East Africa Crude Oil Pipeline, is under development and it is intended to transport crude oil from Uganda's oil fields to Port of Tanga, Tanzania, on the Indian Ocean. Report by Jadiat Namoya for Aben TV.